Hey everybody, coming to you from the Museum of Transportation over here on Barrett Station Road in St. Louis, Missouri. And I thought I'd give you a little update on this 1966 Union Pacific Rotary Snowplow. I've done a few videos on this in the past, and it seemed like everybody had a lot of interest in it. So I thought I'd give you a little update and just show you the progress, because in my last video, I showed you that they began cleaning it up and restoring it a bit. And I just wanted to show you how that was coming along. And we'll take a look at it here. This is the heaviest rotary snowplow ever built. It weighs about 367,000 pounds. And it takes three or four locomotives to actually push this down the track. And so it's definitely an impressive machine. You can see it has those huge 12-foot blades, a huge rotary blade there. And of course that chucks the snow right out the chute at the top. And boy, it can really throw it out there, that's for sure. Just pretty crazy looking. You can see it's got those giant 12-foot rotary blades that really spit the snow out. And let me tell you, if you haven't seen it yet, check out some of the videos on YouTube of these in action, because it's pretty impressive. You can see up here that they've painted all the blades and they've even numbered them, if you can see that. So they have each blade numbered as you go around. And then the little chute here that kind of guides the snow in, they've painted that all yellow, and then they've added some black striping to that as well. But they've definitely cleaned it up nicely. It's looking impressive. And along the sides here, this is all stainless steel sheeting on the outside. But there's some plain steel racks up top. And the problem they had was, you know, over the years, those painted racks up top start to rust. And the rust was running down the sides and streaking everything. To get into this thing to even operate it. Pretty cool. I mean, it's just a really massive. And you can see they've got almost all the rust gone, and definitely looks a lot more impressive. And I noticed they've also painted in the letters, so that looks really nice as well. Very cool. I mean, it is definitely a massive machine. You can see these markers here, and that's so they can see the snow depth. And that's in feet. And you can see right up front there at the top of the chute, it goes up over 12 feet. And then of course you have your cabin up there where you're gonna drive from. And that's pretty neat too. The windshield, they even have these circular devices on there that actually clean the windshield off as you go, because it, you know, of course would wanna freeze up and everything. And you have your fuel tanks down below. Here we'll go ahead and check out the board on it. Once again, it's a 1966 Union Pacific. And let's see if we can see all the details here. But yeah, 367,400 pounds. And takes three or four locomotives to push it. And there's a few videos on YouTube of similar rotary snow plows actually in operation, so you might want to check those out, because it is pretty impressive. And I mean, you can see they've cleaned it up all the way around, and still have all the warning stickers and that sort of thing. They were able to preserve all that. And I mean, they weren't like full-on restoring it back to perfect, they were just trying to clean it up so that you know, just for a better presentation. And they've definitely done a nice job on it. And in my previous videos, if you'll look back, I actually have a tour of the inside where we walked up inside the cabin, checked out all the controls, and then we actually walked down through the back and took a look at that giant diesel engine back there. That thing's about as big as a room in your house. Very impressive. Here, I'll go ahead and give you a look at the other side while we're here. But definitely some menacing looking blades, that's for sure. But As you can see, they've done a nice job cleaning it up. I mean, it looks a lot better than the last time I was over here. Very nice. Alright guys, well I just wanted to give you a little update on that. Looks like they've made really good progress with it since the last time I was here. And I'll make sure that I put some links in the information below the video so you can check out the previous videos I have on it. Because it's definitely an impressive machine. Well, hopefully you found it interesting. I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have. And I'll see you later. Bye.